Raw.
Hey little sister.
Hey Miranda.
Are you gonna let me in, or are you gonna stand there and look at me like that?
Come on in. Someone's in a good mood today.
Girl, yeah, and guess why?
Why?
Me and Kenny just moved into our new house. It's fancy, expensive and much bigger than your shoebox apartment.
Good for you.
What's wrong with you? Every time I come over here, you're always giving me that look.
Miranda, have you ever considered the fact that I don't always want to hear you brag about your perfect life? Especially in my situation.
Melissa, calm down. I'm not bragging about anything. It's not my fault that you can't afford expensive stuff.
Wow, you just proved my point.
How?
You just called me broke.
No, I didn't.
You called my apartment a shoebox and said I couldn't afford what you can.
Well, it's true. Geez, learn how to take a joke.
I would, if you didn't mock my financial problems.
I just came here to hang out and this is how you treat me?
So now you're playing the victim. You literally let yourself in my house and talk trash about me.
I can't even make a joke because you just have to get offended by everything.
No, you're being a snooty ass bitch. You need to leave. Come back and hang out with me when you have a better attitude and you're ready to apologize to me.
Fine, I'll just go. Hello Miranda. Hey mom, what's wrong? I thought you'd be happy to have dinner with me. Now you look like your sister. Melissa kicked me out of her apartment. Oh god, what did you do?
It wasn't my fault. I was just coming to tell her that I moved into the new house.
Okay, and she was jealous that I'm living the life she wished she had. And what did she say?
She called me a snooty ass bitch.
Oh my, why would she say that?
Because she's jealous of me.
Did you brag about your lifestyle and belittle her?
Yeah, then you deserved to be called a snooty ass bitch.
I didn't even call her broke directly. How did she know what I meant?
Read between the lines.
Oh.
Look, if you're here to brag about your perfect life, I don't wanna hear it.
No, I just wanna say I'm sorry for how I acted. I wanted to know if you wanted to come see the place.
Sure.
Okay. Great. Here we are.
Wow, this is so cool.
I know, not like you can afford it.
What?
Nothing.
That's what I thought. Anyway, I have to go to work. See you next time. Welcome to Starbucks. How may I be of service?
I need a frappuccino with extra whipped cream.
Okay, that will be $4. Here's your order.
Are you dumb? I said extra whipped cream.
I'm sorry, I can get you extra.
You should know how to do your job. It's easy.
It's not as easy as it looks. If you wanna be a Karen, then do it somewhere else.
Let me speak to your manager.
No, if you don't leave, then you can speak to security.
What seems to be the problem?
Are you the manager?
Yes, I am.
This girl is incompetent. She forgot my extra whipped cream. Tried to kick me out and called me a Karen. You need to fire her.
I can't fire her for that.
Yes, you can. Fire her right now.
I said no.
Do you have any idea who you are talking to? I am on the board of directors that literally runs this place. Fire her. Right now.
Melissa, I'm sorry but, I have to let you go.
Please, I need this job.
I'm sorry but, she's on the board of directors that runs this place. I have to terminate your employment here.
Fuck you.
Melissa, what's wrong?
I got fired.
What? Why?
For no reason, some Karen in the store got me fired.
Wait a minute. Did this woman have a Karen haircut and sunglasses?
Yes.
That's Karen Drexler. She's on the board of directors and she's my employee. As of now, she's fired. And I'll make sure you get your job back.
Thanks.
Do we have to go to the diner?
Yeah, we can't always spend money on expensive food.
I would not be caught dead in that thing you call a restaurant. I hope nobody sees me in this dump.
Wow, you're so used to living in lavish that you forgot what the real world is like.
Hello, I'm Lois. May I take your order? Oh, you're Melissa's friend. Anyway, I guess I'll take a cheeseburger with curly fries.
And I'll have a hot dog with the Coca-Cola.
Okay, can you buy me a Birkin?
I just bought you one last month.
Well, I need another one.
Oh, all right, fine.
Now what?
I wanted to invite you to my housewarming party.
Sure, I got nothing better to do.
Great, it's on Saturday at 5 p.m.
Okay, I'll be there. Can I invite Tito and Lois?
Sure.
Thanks.
What was I thinking? Letting her broke friends in my expensive house. I'll just get some stuff for the party. Oh look, there's an empty spot.
Excuse me, miss, but that was my parking spot. Did you not see me about to beckon?
You snooze, you lose, honey. You better start looking before you lose another one.
Wait, you're the girl from the Starbucks. I got you fired for doing a poor job. So you got me fired. Your dad is my boss.
I have no idea what you're talking about. I've never worked a day in my life. I don't even know you.
Yeah, you do. You just dyed your hair.
That last part is true, but guess what? My mom owns this store. As far as I know, you're supposed to be in her office in 10 minutes for an interview. Don't bother coming to that interview. I'll make sure that my mom is aware of you, and she will not hire you.
Please, I need this job. My daughter is sick and I'm on edge.
Yet you saw it as your right to cause my sister to lose her job. You're just sorry that you got caught, and that I'm gonna expose you. Bye, bitch. Hey, Donna.
Hey, Miranda.
Are you and Miles still coming to the housewarming?
Yeah, I'm going dress shopping.
Sure. I'll just let Kenny do the grocery shopping. Oh, we have to wait for the fitting room to be open.
Yeah. Ah ha 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 ha.
What's wrong?
Girl, someone's still in the fitting room, and someone left their loud child unattended. Like, who does that? What's wrong with him?
He's probably autistic. I have a niece just like him.
Ah, is his mother special needs too? This is ridiculous. I need a dress for this party. I have been waiting for over 20 minutes and someone had the nerve to leave their loud child to annoy everybody in the store. Boy, you need to sit down somewhere. What's wrong with you, stupid little idiot?
Excuse me, what did you say to my son?
Mommy, the lady hurt my feelings.
I know. Don't worry, Mommy will handle her. Miss, what is wrong with you?
What's wrong with me? What's wrong with your son? Your little idiot has been making noises for almost a half an hour. Can he chill with all that noise?
I'm sorry, but Brian's autistic, and you have no right to speak to a child like that.
Well, I said it, and Brian needs to go to a mental facility. You just slapped the shit out of me.
Keep my son's name out your fucking mouth.
But it's true.
Keep my son's name out your fucking mouth.
Okay, I am. Actually, Donna, I don't even want this dress. Let's go. I'm glad you could come.
Me too, and Tito and Lois will be here soon. Hey Tito, this is my sister Miranda. And Miranda, this is my boyfriend Tito.
Oh, I didn't know you had a boyfriend.
Yeah, we've been together for 2 weeks. Every day he tells me how much he loves me.
I thought no guy would date you because of how broke you are.
Don't start. Who are those people?
Tito and Lois. They're Melissa's broke friends. I shouldn't have invited that brokey, let alone her friends.
They look like nice people.
Hey Miranda.
Why are you dating my sister?
Because I love her.
She works at Starbucks for crying out loud.
And I work at a taco truck.
So you're a brokey too?
Excuse me?
Oh, you know, you can't afford nice things.
Why are you acting like this? I didn't do anything to you.
Because there are two types of people in this world. There's my type, who live in lavish and are rich. And there's your type, who are poor and work in low-paying jobs. Wow, Miranda, what is wrong with you? Mind your business, Lois. Nobody's talking to you. But I'm talking to you. I see why Melissa doesn't like you. You stay out of my business.
Miranda, you need to chill. Keep on, and I'll tell Kenny what you said to us and he'll break up with you.
You better not. If we're being honest, I think he should. Shut up, Lois. I thought I told you to mind your own business. What are you gonna do if I don't? Get the hell out of my house. Fine. I didn't want to come to your stupid party anyway.
Lois, where are you going?
I'm leaving. Your sister's really rude. She called us broke.
I know, she does this all the time. Look what you did. Tito and Lois left because you couldn't stop being a bitch.
Is it being a bitch if I'm telling the truth?
That's it. Don't talk to me ever again. And do not call my phone again.
Dad, do you have a minute?
Sure, what's up?
It's about Melissa. She's not talking to me anymore.
What did you do now?
It wasn't my fault. Actually, it was my fault.
What did you do?
I made fun of her friends at the housewarming party.
What did you say?
I told Tito that he was broke with a low-paying job, which he does. Then me and Lois had a screaming match and then I kicked her out.
Did Melissa say anything?
She tried to make me apologize and I refused.
Is that why she cut off all contact with you?
Yeah, none of this would have happened if Melissa didn't get offended by everything.
Here I am thinking that you were finally going to take responsibility for your wrongdoing. And you're still blaming your sister.
But I'm sorry.
I thought you were too, but since you continue to blame Melissa, you've proved to me that you're not sorry at all. You're just sorry that your sister doesn't want anything to do with you. You were 21 years old, and you continue to act like a child on the playground. I'm sorry, but I'm on Melissa's side.
I am not going down without a fight. You hear me?
Didn't I tell you not to call me?
Melissa, I just want you to come over so I can give you a face-to-face apology.
Fine. But you better not be lying.
Hey Melissa, how have you been?
Oh please Miranda, you already know why I'm here. Let's just get this over with so I can go on my date.
Oh, you have a date?
Are you going to apologize or not? I knew you were lying, I'll just leave.
No please.
That's it, I'm leaving.
Melissa, get back here right now.
I already gave you a plethora of chances to make things right. We're not sisters anymore. We're done. You shot me. What the fuck is wrong with you?
Bitch.
Donna, help me. Miranda shot me. Miles, call 911. Miranda shot Melissa.
911, what's your emergency?
A friend of mine got shot by her sister.
Oh my goodness, what are the names of the two sisters?
Melissa and Miranda Rogers. They're identical twins. Miranda has pink hair. My address is 139 Lincoln Avenue. Miranda's address is 125 Lincoln Avenue.
Oh God, I don't even know where to begin.
I did something bad.
Brielle, just put the gun down.
I can't. I just shot my own sister.
Please put the gun down.
I didn't want to hurt her. I'm so sorry, Melissa. Please tell me she's still alive.
We don't know yet.
Ah. I can't believe it. How could Miranda do such a thing?
Now she's going to jail for something so stupid. Doctor, how's my daughter doing?
She lost a lot of blood.
Is she okay?
I'm sorry. She passed away 5 minutes ago.
No, please, have mercy. Where's Melissa?
She's dead.
Oh God, no.
Just put the gun down.
No, I don't deserve to live.
Yes, you do.
No, I don't.
Miss Rogers, you've been in this car for 10 hours. It's time to come out.
Okay, I'm coming out.
You're under arrest. You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say may or will be used against you in a court of law. You have the right to an attorney if you can afford one. If you cannot afford one, one will be provided to you. Do you understand these rights as I have explained them to you?
Yes.
Let's go.
How's Melissa doing?
She didn't make it.
What do you mean she didn't make it?
She died hours ago.
Ah.
Why did you kill Melissa?
I didn't mean to. I was just trying to incapacitate her. I didn't want to kill her.
Why did you want to incapacitate her?
We've always been rivals. She would always give me the cold shoulder, and would give me attitude.
That's not a good excuse. In fact, there is no excuse for what you did. You're going to your cell.
Today we're here to pay tribute to Melissa Rogers.
Ms. Rogers, you have been found guilty of second-degree murder. I hereby sentence you to life in prison with no chance of parole. Court is now adjourned.
This is your new home. You'll be staying here until the day you die.
I am so sorry, Melissa.
That's all, folks.